It says, this is the bottom, by the way, the second column, second row. To what extent are the frontline employees made aware of the external communications to the customer? Tell your frontline about these things. Tell your frontline, Burger King has an ad and you're not honoring it. I think I used this example from the Wendy's near the Florida Hospital the other day. They had the bacon cheeseburger up, and because they're owned by Seventh-day Adventists, they can't serve bacon. That's a problem. Then take the sign down. Don't like advertise it. That's like asking for bacon lovers to be mad. At least offer turkey bacon. Right? So it's those things. When you find yourself fixing errors like that all day, you have a right to get mad at management. You have a right to complain. So there's another kind of communications, and that's internal. So it says minimize horizontal communication between all departments. Horizontal just means departments within a company. Horizontal means like within the same, like sales to salespeople. Vertical communication might mean frontline to top management. But what happens is horizontal and vertical communication breakdowns happen. Salespeople, marketing, and in the little triangle, it should say operations. It doesn't say operations there, it should say operations. But the example I like to use about this is a country club. The salespeople sell a wedding on the 18th hole of the golf course. There's a golf tournament that day. They don't tell operations they did so. Operations get the note from the golf about the tournament, and they get a note from sales about the wedding. And they go, that dog won't hunt. That's an example of this communication problems that happen within and between departments in a company. So you want to minimize that. It's the same thing as the engineering problem and the marketing problem in automotive. It's the chef versus the front of the house. Chef Jerry at the Polo Fields Country Club, he had an Italian chef. He was amazing. He would go out and check on our tables. And the tables love that. They love that. That's why I think Bonefish having their servers dressed like chefs is a good idea. Because people see that, they perceive it as the chef or someone very knowledgeable in food. But what happened, a lot of times I would put notes to the server, Chef Jerry's menu is new today. Here are five terms that you're not going to know what means. What we couldn't do, if you go to Chef Jerry in the middle of the rush and say, are there pine nuts on your special for today? He would like want to cut somebody's head off. Like, what? They're asking me now in a public special? And it's 3 hours later? He would go all to hell. So I knew that I acted as a shock absorber with those kind of things. And I warned the employees through that little list. Look what pine nuts are. Look what this is. Look this up. Look what's in the featured item. And so what I tried to do is minimize those communication errors through that little newsletter. I stopped doing that newsletter. All the quiet employees came and asked me where the newsletter was. All the talkers didn't very much read it, but they'll come and ask you. So I learned that that newsletter was also for the quiet employees. They liked it. You know, some people are very quiet and thoughtful and perfectionists, and they don't formulate their thoughts as quickly as mouths. So they can't ever get their points in. So it's very important to have communication devices designed. So those are the four principles related to measurement of service. You're going to have a chance to do the essay for the final exam on the measurement of service. I give you an article by Piney Gilmore on the experience economy along with this handout. And I ask you to pick a business and do some service redesign of that business. Any questions on principle 3 and 4?